How to cut tennis balls. Tennis balls can be used for more than just playing games. When they're cut open, you can slide them onto furniture legs or walkers to protect your floors and move them around easier. If you cut a tennis ball in half, you can use the halves as massagers to help alleviate foot and back pain. Cutting a tennis ball is an easy process as long as you're careful not to cut yourself. Method 1: Cutting tennis balls for furniture. Hold the tennis ball firmly against a solid surface. Set the tennis ball on a surface that's knife safe, such as a cutting board. Grip the tennis ball in your non-dominant hand so the rounded edge of the seam faces up. Use your ring finger and pinky to support the back of the ball so it doesn't roll away. If you don't feel comfortable holding the ball while you cut it, secure the ball in a vise grip. Poke the blade of a utility knife through the middle of the ball. Hold the knife with your dominant hand so your index finger is along the top edge and pointing toward the blade. Carefully poke the end of your knife in between the seams until it breaks into the center of the ball. Make sure the blade isn't pointed toward your fingers or you could accidentally cut yourself if the knife slips. You may also use a craft knife, but it may not be as strong as a utility knife. Cut a 1.5" (3.8 cm) slit in the ball. Move your blade up and down to saw through the ball's rubber. Make a straight horizontal cut parallel to the seams that's about 1.5" (3.8 cm) long. When you're finished with the cut, pull your knife out of the ball. Don't make your slit any longer or else it could easily fall off of furniture legs. Rotate the ball by 90 degrees and make another slit. Turn the ball so the slit you cut is vertical when you look at it. Press the tip of the knife 3/4" (1.9 cm) to the left of the first slit near its midpoint. Make a horizontal cut that crosses the first slit so it forms an X shape. Once your second slit is 1.5" (3.8 cm) long, take your knife out. Tip: if you find it difficult to make one continuous cut, start your knife in the center of the first slit and make a 3/4" (1.9 cm) perpendicular cut. Then, rotate the ball 180 degrees and make another 3/4" (1.9 cm) cut that lines up with the other. Leave the ball near a window or well-ventilated area for one day to dry any moisture. Sometimes, tennis balls have a small amount of moisture inside them that could damage furniture legs. Set the ball on a windowsill so the cut faces down. Let the ball dry out for about one day before putting it on anything. Once the ball doesn't have an odor, it's ready to use. Method 2: Halving a tennis ball. Trace a line around the circumference of the ball. Hold the ball steady on your work surface with your non-dominant hand. Draw a straight line in the direction you want to cut on top of the ball with a pen. Rotate the ball when you need to continue your line around its surface. Make sure the ends of your line meet so you know it's straight. If a pen doesn't work on your tennis ball, use a marker. The marker line will be noticeable when you finish your cut. Hold the ball from above against a hard surface. Set the ball on a cutting board or another surface where you can easily use a knife. Hold the ball with your non-dominant hand so all of your fingers are gripping it. Keep 3 fingers on the front of the ball, and support the back side with your pinky and thumb. Make sure your cut line is between your front and back fingers. Imagine your hand as a claw so you're only grabbing the ball with the ends of your fingers. Start your cut with a serrated knife. Feed the blade of your knife underneath your hand so it's between your front and back fingers. Use firm pressure as you saw back and forth along the cut line. Continue cutting until you're halfway through the ball before removing your knife. Stay attentive while you make your cut so you don't accidentally hurt yourself. Warning: this cut will dull your knives if you plan on cutting multiple tennis balls. Rotate the ball to finish making your cut. Turn the ball by 90 degrees along the line you drew and hold it firmly again. Stick the blade of your knife into the cut you started and continue working along the line you drew. Keep rotating the ball by 90 degrees and cutting until it's halved. Turning the ball makes it easier to cut and helps ensure your halves are the same size. Finished. Warnings: never cut toward your fingers or else you may hurt yourself. Things you'll need: cutting tennis balls for furniture, cutting board, utility knife, having a tennis ball, pen, cutting board, serrated knife.